we had analyzed information that was acquired from the Election Commission database. So it did come as a surprise that there were multiple voters having living in the same residence. When we conducted the survey, we found out that these people actually didn't even exist because the person who owned the house don't know who they are.
So our finding, we find out that it's not just hundreds or tens, we are talking about a number of thousands of those we actually suspected to be the country workers. So of course we are launching a report here today because we like to find out more. We like to have our police force to actually to investigate properly the eligibility of all of these phantom voters. Are they really a phantom voters or they are really staying in the house?
When you look at the statistics of increase in new voters in Wangsa Maju, it was very slow in 2014 and 2015. Then suddenly in quarter 4, 3 and 4, the number shot up by tenfold even, in numbering in terms of thousands. Now, the question here is that, how come there is a sudden increase in quarter 3 and quarter 4 of 2016? And the nature of the increase is that many voters are put inside a single house. You can't have about a dozen voters staying in a 600 square feet apartment. Also, when you look at it, is that you have to ask, how come the JPN can allow issuance of such IC? Because they need to support or substantiate their residential address. Now this is one question for the JPN. The second more important question is that with so many malpractices being discovered in quarter 3 and quarter 4 of 2016, how come suddenly in quarter 1, without justification, SPR forbid the issuance of electoral roll in database format for all the political parties and interested parties to study the increases? Because they are only giving us in hard copy PDF format with incomplete information. That itself shows certainly that SPR have a lot of things to hide.
We are lodging a police report against 240 phantom voters who use false addresses to register as voters for Wangsa Maju. All the 240 phantom voters are from the polling district of Taman Melati. Based on our checking on the ground, in one polling district of Taman Melati alone, there are 240 voters who are found not living or have not been lived and have not lived in the addresses as shown in the electoral roll of SPR. There are 17 polling districts in Wangsa Maju, and nearly all have been contaminated with phantom voters. According to our initial estimation, there are at least 4,000 phantom voters who have been injected into Wangsa Maju. Now, a few days ago, the UMNO Wilayah Chief, Dato Sri Tengku Anan, told the Wangsa Maju delegates that Wangsa Maju and Lempa Pantai are the two prime targets of UMNO to win back in the next general election. We would like to know if the confidence of UMNO to win in Wangsa Maju comes from these 4,000 phantom voters. Me and my team from Wangsa Maju will continue to expose these phantom voters in every polling district, and we will not hesitate to lodge police report against them. It is obvious that it is a criminal offense in the case of phantom voters. Therefore, we urge the police to take our report of these phantom voters very seriously, because phantom voters do not just take away the right of the genuine voters from Wangsa Maju and damage destroy the democratic process in the general election. And more importantly, if a large number of ICs are using false addresses, it could pose a very serious danger to the national security. Therefore, the police must take action.